Hey guys, welcome back. I'm finally doing the normal Red Dead Redemption series. Nope, there's my boy John right there. Oh, Johnny, Johnny, Johnny. Bill Williamson. I don't like that freaking guy on the right. Red Dead Redemption. Well, he's just chilling in the frickin' train. Oh, Johnny boy. Yeah, right. That's a load of horseshit.
But Father, do you mean unless an innocent receives communion, they're destined to go to hell? Hardly seems fair.
What I mean to say, Jenny, is that there is a great deal of difference between an innocent and a savage.
I never thought of it that way.
Yes, they live like animals, but they're happier now.
Assholes. Miss McFarland? You've been judgmental ever since my character got off the damn train.
Apparently, the John family have made a lot of money, and he has a lot of friends in politics.
Mrs. Bush, money isn't everything. There are many things that money cannot buy.
It seems that money can buy votes, though.
Oh, armadillo.
What you must remember, my dear, is that we have been brought here to spread the word. And the word and civilization, they are the same thing. They are the gifts. It is the opportunity.
Yeah, that's freaking Miss McFarland from the last game. Look, guys. The fuck is she doing on the train?
And who let that you worship in peace.
It's so confusing, Father. Sometimes I find it impossible to make the distinction between a loving act and a hateful one. I mean, they often seem to be the same thing.
Yes, Jenny, it is confusing. But you only have to ask me.
Well, here we are, Mrs. Bush. Armadillo.
Damn, all I'm armed with is a damn revolver? Jeez. Nope, looks like a drunk's coming out. Oh, there he goes. Oh, the drunk guy's over there now.
All righty, Mr. Marston, let's get. Take it easy until we're out of town. Ain't no point in causing a ruckus. How are you, partner? Judge a man by the company he keeps, but...
Well, he ain't been friends for a long time.
Guess I'm going up to see old Bill. Bill Williamson. Oh, dear.
Are you planning on spending any time in Armadillo, Mr. Marston?
I doubt it. I ain't planning on staying very long.
Well, if you're fixing for some female company, you could do a lot worse than Armadillo. Fine as cream gravy they are. Not like Steve Grandin. Dang, those girls ain't even fit for a drinking man to hold up with.
I'm a married man, I'm afraid.
Ain't we all?
It's one thing I don't get about men. Always gotta hit on other women up the frickin' when they're married and stuff.
Yeah, so it was the marshal who hired me. Lee Johnson, do you know him?
I think I heard his name.
Says he got a telegram from some Blackwater big bugs asking for a guy. I guess it's none of my business.
That's right.
You ain't very talkative, are you?
Nope.
I'm just chewing the dog, mister. It's how I am. I don't mean nothing by it.
Trust me. There's things you better off not knowing.
At least they're not undead. At least I don't have to deal with that anymore.
Well,
This here is what's left of Fort Mercer. Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand.
This is where we part ways, friend. You have yourself a good time.
Bye, Jakey. So I gotta go up to that X, I suppose. There's someone standing behind there. I saw their shadow. You ain't fooling anyone, bud.
Come out here right now.
Go away now, John. Don't make me kill you.
Nobody needs to kill anyone, Bill.
You must think I was born yesterday. You always did think I was an idiot.
That ain't fair, Bill. You were as my brother. I've come to try to save you.
Oh. Do I look like I need saving?
Bill, please. They want to kill us all. I can help you.
You never tried to save me before. You only seem to save yourself.
Bill. I implore you, think about this.
You implore me? You implore me.
Oh, dear.
You always were one for fancy words. Well, things are different now, John. Now I'm in charge. No more Dutch. And no more you. I implore you to go back and tell them to send someone just a little bit more impressive next time.
Well.
Oh. Game over. I'm dead. Game over. I'm dead. Vultures are gonna be picking at my scrotum pretty soon. Yep. Lots of or maybe not. I hope it's Bonnie McFarlane again. So kind of you to kidnap me, but okay.
Well, you're alive.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
I don't know the polite word for it.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die, Mr.
Mr. Marston. John Marston.
Bonnie McFarland. Miss Bonnie.
You may be right, Miss McFarland. I don't know.
So what were you giving her?
Trying to give Mr. Williamson a chance. For old time's sake.
You know Bill Williamson?
Knew him. Long time ago.
Well, what was he like?
Dumb.
Just like you.
Thank you, miss. See my hat?
I have.
See my hat?
What will you do now?
Now I'm gonna take my time and go after him the less kind way.
Well, that sounds very fun, Mr. Marston. Quite heroic, just like in those penny dreadfuls my brother used to read. Meanwhile, if you'll excuse me, I've got a ranch to run. Of course, if you're feeling better, why not take a ride with me later and help me patrol the perimeter? You can earn back some of that money we wasted on doctor's appointments.
Of course. And thank you for saving my life from that.
Next time, Mr. Marston, I strongly recommend you don't try to lose your collection, honestly.
I'll bear that in mind.
Oh, for fuck's sakes.
Mr. Marston, back in the land of the living, I see.
Figured it's about time I started paying back that $15.
Well, no time to waste. The horses are saddled up over here.
I call the black one.
There's the foreman. He's also going to lock up 6 or 7 outlaws.
I'm happy enough with my current quarters right now, Mr. McFarland.
Let's make a tour of the ranch so you can get your bearings.
Come on!
Chicken! I want meat.
Very convenient. I don't think I've ever seen a ranch with its own store before.
And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
I suspect you've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase. Station. Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished, bringing in all sorts of new folk like yourself.
Is that such a bad thing?
Change is only good when it makes things better.
Farland.
had a cold drink, Mr. Marston.
Thank you, ma'am. Getting shot, then riding a horse seems to take it out of you.
Sure. Come on, man. Let's mount up and take a look around.
Now I got a rifle. Why do I have a feeling she has a crush on him?
Look, those damn rabbits are at the crops again. Get down and give me a hand, will you? Get your rifle out. It's about time these little thieves met their maker.
Something I've had a little experience in.
Maybe Bill Williamson did get lucky after all.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarland.
Well, guys, that's going to have to wrap up the first episode of Red Dead Redemption. If you guys enjoyed it, leave a like and a comment and subscribe. And please follow me on TikTok. Peace out.